Hey love bugs, it's Roslynn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored, and definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time stopping by my channel, much love to you and welcome. And to my returning subs, my growing extended beautiful family, just thank you so much for the love and support. Being able to connect with people on so many different levels and being able to resonate with other situations and knowing that you are not alone is truly a blessing. So with that being said, much love to all. Namaste, love and blessings, love and light, and many blessings are definitely coming your way. And if you have been watching my videos for a while and I have not already, please like and subscribe, even hit that notification bell at the bottom so you know when your girl's about to upload her next video. Also, if you are comfortable enough, I would love the chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me, even if it's about the positive feedback or the content of my video, or you're just up telling me about your empathic gift and how it impacts your life and you towards a positive direction. Also, if you feel like the videos gave you good information or good vibes that you would love to share with a loved one, family, or friend, please go ahead and do so. Please share, even though, you know, going through dark times and they need confirmation or validation towards their life path or even their soul purpose. And while you're at it, give me a thumbs up, like, and also share on your social media favorites wherever you see fit. Thank you once again for the love and support that you've been giving me. It's truly appreciated. And I love y'all from the bottom of my heart for that. And I hope you're able to resonate with the content of my video. And today, I'm going to turn that up a little bit because you really can't hear it. It's called Magic Happens When You Connect Into the Present Moment of Now. Powerful Miracles, ASMR 3D Nature. And I will post that link in the description box below. I'm starting to like these ASMR videos because a lot of them, you know, like if it's with people eating and stuff, I can't stand it because when they start smacking, it drives me nuts. I'm like, dang, I would love to enjoy your mukbang, but shoot, I can't get past the, you know, the smacking part, so I stopped looking at certain people because of that. But anyways, for that being said, my video today is about Twin Flame 101. Heyoka's Don't Settle. Don't settle when you deserve better. And it's truly, it is so true, because sometimes, you know, you can be in a situation where you just don't want to be lonely, or, you know, just want to feel like you're being loved. I've done it. I've seen other people do it. Some people get mad at me because I call them out on it. I'm like, well, shoot, you want me to keep it real with you? I keep it real to the realest of the realest. You know, I said, because the fact is, if I know I did it and I can spot somebody else doing it, you know, a lot of people don't like it when you call them out on that. And some people appreciate your honesty. It just depends on what type of person that is. But a lot of times we tend to be around people because we want friends. Those are not your real friends. If you see that they're constantly putting you down, belittling you, or, you know, not having that support that you have in your dreams, because like I tell people all the time, if you've been with me for a while, you have heard me say, if people can't see themselves in their dreams or see themselves going towards their dreams, they cannot see yours. And just because they might have tried to go out for their dreams and it failed, you know, they'll try to do the same thing to you because they feel like, you know, they don't want you being in that show of support. They'll be right behind you, you know, trying to make sure that they sabotage your goals, sabotage your dreams, having you second guess those. You know, I've seen a lot of people be in certain situations on being in a relationship just to say they've been in relationships, or just feel like they need to have that closeness, that connection. You know, I've been that, you know, being in sexually encountered with people just because I want to be able to feel that connection, and that's still not good, because after all that, you're like, ugh, I could have waited. I could have waited because I didn't feel the connect. The connection only lasted during that moment of, you know, pure bliss. And the next thing you know, when it's all over with, you know, it's just like, you know, hey, I don't know. But it's just like, when you deserve better, you know, if it tends for you have to be by yourself at times, you know, be by yourself. Because it beats being in a situation with a whole bunch of people and still feeling lonely. And I've been in a situation where I can be around a group of people just to say, oh, I got a handful of friends. And next thing you know, them handful of friends don't get me. They're not on the same level as me. I can't have a conversation with them, a real conversation with them, unless it's like gossiping, going to the club, smoking, drinking, or getting high. And if it's like, if I got to do all those situations just to be around you, that's not meant for me to do, because it's like a lot of people ask me, Roslynn, you want to hang? I'm like, boo, I don't smoke, I don't drink, you know, I don't get high, and I don't like going to clubs. So what are we going to do? Because it's like, we're going to be sitting up here looking at each other like, well, that was a waste of time. So go on about your business. So it's just like, now I love to gravitate towards people that are on my level, you know, being able to, you know, it's just like going out to clubs. You know, I was invited to a club and I'm just like, I will feel weird. What am I supposed to be, designated driver? Because it's like, I've not been to a club before when I didn't have a stimulant, you know, smoking before I went to the club, having a couple of drinks before I went to the club. I wouldn't know how to act unless it was somebody who doesn't do those things. Then maybe we'd be able to go. But, you know, it's just like all those different things. You never should settle because you're lonely. I used to, you know, I've told people before, you know, I've hung around with people that I truly did not see at that time. It was really using me, you know, because I didn't want to be alone with my thoughts. So that was like when I was going through a spiritual awakening. I didn't know what it was. I was just like, I just don't like being alone with my thoughts. And a lot of people were looking at me like, girl, what's wrong with you? You know, and it was hard to explain, you know, because I didn't know what I was feeling. I was getting other people's, you know, emotions, you know, it was gravitating towards my weight because I did not know what I was experiencing at that time. So it was very scary for me. But other people that were, you know, that were still in that sleep state, they really thought something was mentally wrong with me. And it was just like, now I can see it for what it is. And people would be like, hanging with me, I say, nah, that wouldn't be a good idea. Or if somebody wanted to talk to me, I'm like, nah, that wouldn't be a good idea. Because there's sometimes I could be going through something and somebody was like, Roslynn, can I call you? Not right now. We can text, but no, not right now. I'm not, you know, the vibes that I'm giving off. Or even at that time, I say it has to be another time, because it's just, I don't want to reciprocate those type of vibes with anybody. You know, those are the times you need to be in solitude. Those are the times you need to reflect on self and try to heal self, whatever you have going on at that time. So it's just like, when you're feeling some type of way, give yourself that self-worth and that self-love to know you don't need to be around anybody that's going to make you feel bad about who you truly are or make you question who you are. You know, if they're sending out something therapeutically to have you look at, because there's sometimes, you know, people will tell me what's going on with them. And I try to send, you know, the most positive response to that, because I tell them maybe that wasn't the path you were supposed to go, or, you know, maybe that person wasn't meant to be in your life like that, you know. And it's just a lot of times people get upset because things happen a certain way or somebody ghosts them, and I'm just like, maybe what that person wasn't supposed to be in your life like that. Look at it that way, you know. Yeah, it can be a hurtful thing, yeah, be a sad situation, but take that blessing for what it's worth. You never know, a lot of times for you disconnecting from a lot of different people, it's a blessing in disguise, because you might have some blessings coming on along. And a lot of times some people with that, you know, some empaths are not, you know, them real empaths like that, because some of them are very deceptive. A lot of them will ask you certain things, like I said in my other video, they prey upon your downfall, that, you know, don't want you to exceed because they see their life ain't about really nothing. Even though their life can be about something if they put their effort towards it, but if they don't feel like, oh, that means work. Everything deserves work. Everything means work. If you really want something in your life, universe will have you keep going at it. Even if it has you hitting wall to wall to wall to wall, they got to see, okay, are they going to give up quick on this? Because if they give up quick on it, that means they didn't really want that. Because if they really going hard for it and grinding for it, they'll be just like, wait a minute, hold up. They really want this in their life. They're going to, you know, they're taking it, you know, even though they're taking them L's, like left and right, left and right, left and right. They are still allowing themselves to be like, you know what? They really want that in their life. So allow yourself to be around the people that are on your level. Allow yourself, you know, because there's a lot of times you cannot be around sleep people when you're wide awake, because it's not going to make you be talking to them about stuff and they're not going to get what you're saying. And they're not, because there was time people that were woke in their woke state and I wasn't fully awake yet. They were like, no, you got to go through it to get to it for you to understand what I was talking about. Now I see what they were talking about. Because if I wasn't ready, a lot of people aren't going to be ready to receive the messages you're trying to send out. They're not. So you have to be able to take it for what it's worth on that situation and keep it moving. But, you know, like I said, give yourself that credit, give yourself that self-love and worth. You know, the people that are meant to be in your life, they will gravitate to you. So keep working on self. You know, if it means like relationship wise give yourself that time to heal in all aspects when you're trying to heal. Because if you're trying to be in a relationship and you're not fully healed from the situations that you've been placed in before, are you still feeling some type of way about relationship goals, period? Allow yourself to heal. Allow yourself to be able to work on what you need to work on. And when you finally do all that, then it will be ready for you to be able to bring somebody in your life that truly deserves to be with you, and they have the same kind of goals you do. And even if it comes to friendships as well, you don't need to be around somebody who's going to prey on your downfall, question who you are as a person, question, you know, look at you like you're crazy, like, you know, then, you know, separate yourself. Or people that are very secretive, that's one thing. If they are asking you to tell your life story but leaving little to the imagination when it comes to yours, you have to guess about theirs. Those are the type of people you really need to watch out for, because I had a lot of folks that's like that. But I hope that was able to help you. I hope you were able to resonate with the content of this video. Please drop me a line. I would love to hear your feedback on this. You know, give me a thumbs up, like, and also share on the social media favorites wherever you see fit. Subscribe if you haven't already. And, you know, give me the thumbs up. It's greatly appreciated. So, let me see. I'm going to get my post notification shout out to Treasured Seasons. Robert Cole, as well as Ray Fisher. Much love to you as well. And I'll see you on my next video. And Mimi B, much love to you as well, too, sis. And, you know, send out as much love and light and positivity as you possibly can. Know that you are truly blessed, highly favored, forever loved, and knowing there's always somebody out there praying for your better days. Especially me, I pray for y'all each and every day on your better days. And send out as much love and light and positivity as you possibly can. You never know what your kind words really send somebody, because you never know what they're going through. So I'll see you on my next video. Love you from the bottom of my heart. And have a great day and peace.